Okay. Let's recap. So if you haven't been following this on the YouTube, or you haven't caught the previous streams, here's the situation. A tiny bit boned. Overall, we're actually doing pretty well. We're doing acceptably well, is what we're doing. If we take a look, for example, say, at the technologies count, there we are in second place. We're three technologies away from ahead of Korea. And as you know, Korea has a massive technological advantage in civilization. It, like, Korea equals technology. We're three techs ahead of them. And five techs ahead of everyone else that's closest. And then you have Russia. Because, hey, NCFerum88. Anyway, thank you very much for the sub. Because a lot of people will rank civilizations in Civ 5 on terms of power, right? And there's like the god tier, the absolute best people that you can play. And that includes someone like Poland, for example, very strong. Any of the tech-centric people, Korea, Babylon, I think they tend to be rated extremely high. You know, there's a handful of people like that that are in the top tier. I don't think Russia is considered to be like god tier, top tier civilization to play as a player, either in single player or multiplayer. However, as an AI, Russia always does stupendously well. And I think it might be because her abilities tend to work out pretty well. Yeah. Oh, okay. Let me get right back to that one. Her abilities, Catherine the Great's abilities, might work well as an AI. Maybe, you know, her unique units and buildings and abilities and things like that tend to combo well. But I suspect what happens is just every AI in the game has, like, there's this huge spreadsheet of their tendency of how they, like, how they act, how likely they are to declare war, how expansive they are, and so on and so forth. And I suspect that the numbers for Russia just happen to work out really well for the AI. So Russia always does really good. And part of the problem, I always seem to run into Russia when she's on the other side of the map. So I can't do early duels. So as a result, she's way ahead on tech and on land. Lord Mime, thank you very much for the donation. For the birthday booze and chocolate fund, thank you very much. Appreciate that. That's very generous. Really, really, really very nice. Gonna have a good birthday. Not as good as last year. Last year, of course, is when I decided to do the YouTube thing full time, and that was a very good birthday. This year, we get to celebrate the fact that it is still working. Okay, so plots and plans. Well, we're gonna need nukes. She is ahead of tech, and a lot of it is military tech. She's got better military tech than we do. She just ran over Morocco. The part of the issue is this. At one point, you had to make a decision between building our tech base, just like hunkering down, making sure we got all our research labs set up and just doing that. Or it's like, okay, do we just focus entirely on military for a little while so that we can take some extra territory? You know, there's some back and forth, the chat, you know, had opinions both ways, but ultimately people wanted, like, all right, we're gonna go and try to take some territory, and then we'll take up right after. And it didn't quite work out. First of all, we weren't quite successful in taking much. I mean, we have taken Casablanca and Rabat here from Morocco, but we weren't actually able to take Marrakesh, which is really, really disappointing. And so as a result, we didn't take quite as much land as we'd hoped, and we weren't able to build up our tech base. Now, we're still wickedly ahead of most of the AI. We're not as quite as far ahead as we'd like in 1920, perhaps. But in terms of the flow of this game, we are ahead of all the AI, except for Russia. So if we made a different decision to just purely tech up, we might have been able to keep up on tech with Russia. On the other hand, they probably would have been even bigger and stronger. So the way to get through this will be nukes. It's the only thing we can use as an equalizer for the military. So we have teched up. I think we've got all the technology. No, we're 5 turns away from nuclear fission, and we're 12 turns away from the Manhattan Project. Kingston, I don't suppose I can tell you to be production focused and shave that off to 8 turns. Good. So in 8 turns, we will start building atomic bombs. We do have 8 uranium, so we can build 8 atomic bombs or 4 nuclear missiles, but we don't have the tech for nuclear missiles yet. There's going to be 8 atomic bombs, and we're going to use that as a way to get started. The other thing I'm going to do is move my spies. Right now, we're not really in a situation to do much. We might still want to counterintelligence in Ottawa, especially, since that's our highest potential city. London, we're also defending, but I think we could move out at this point. And what I want to do is use my spies for vision, basically. I want to sort by Russia. I'm going to go and put a spy in Marrakesh. I want to put another spy in maybe Harar and another one in Tangiers. Get that kind of vision. We're going to hope that these guys won't... That being, this is in occupation. They're not puppeted. Fez is puppeted. Saleh is not, which is interesting. She actually annexed it. Oh, Tangiers is a puppet. So maybe actually I'll watch Saleh. I didn't want to do that. It also doesn't help that I'm in love with Catherine, and therefore I can't really oppose her early on until she becomes a powerhouse. That might be part of the problem. So we want to leave you in Harar. You're rigging elections. I'll let you finish rigging elections, and then we'll move you. In Belgrade here, we're going to move you to Harar right away, though. And what that will do, once they arrive, it will give us vision in that city. You can see, oh, we had one in Moscow, but we pulled them out because they couldn't spy anymore. And that's still fine, but I'm going to get vision of the cities. I want to know if she's got any nukes, and especially planes, and I want to blow the crap out of them with my own atomic bombs. Roscoe! Hey, thanks for the tip. Happy birthday to my favorite YouTuber. Aw, oh, I know my name is long and relatively hard to say. Roscoe, Rascal is fine. There we go. That's good, because that's what I'm going to say. Dino Unit, thanks for the sub. All right, without further ado, I guess we'll go ahead and skip to the next turn. We do have a puppet in Casablanca that we could, and I think should, annex at this point. We won't go into negative happiness. We don't need a mint. We will need a little extra happiness, first of all, with the courthouse. And then it does have a castle already. It does have a castle already. That's good. And then we'll see about filling in some extra blanks at that point. But we're going to need a lot of military production. We're going to finish our research labs, which are very close to being done everywhere. Like, our actual tech rate should be pretty... I wonder if we can find out what that is. Korea hates me. The problem is the only person who shares my ideology is Russia. So that's a bit awkward. Dido and Napoleon are at war. That is not going to help things up, because what I really want them to do is be ready to potentially declare war on Russia. Ideally, Russia will be in another war when we declare on Catherine, so that she'll be occupied. I'd like it very much if she declared war on France. I'm hoping that France doesn't waste too much energy on Carthage, because that would be good. Oh, we need another research lab right in Toronto here, so let's get that going on. And because we're live streaming, I have been, you know, maybe rushing. I realize that I'm not playing quite as strongly as I do in my offline games, because I do tend to pause a little bit more and take breaks between episodes to sort of reevaluate everything. And here we're going a little bit more seat of our pants, which means not necessarily all the way optimized. Thanks, Cyborg. Mint. What about the freshness? Yes. Mint. Great Prophet, your job. You have already done it. You converted Melbourne because it wanted my religion, which is good. Any other city-states that want hockey? The religion of hockey? Yes, in fact, Mbanzo Congo wants it, but it's quite far. And who else is this? Belgrade, which is up there. All right, well, we may as well go ahead and do it. It'd be really nice if we could flip some of these over from Russia, but it's not the end of the world. Can I not get over there? All right, there we go. That was weird. Rocket artillery. We do have rocket artillery on board. We do have aluminum, because we went and took it with this citadel to make sure that we had access to it. We really wanted to grab the one from Saleh from Morocco, but it's not to be. So we're going to get you in position over here and just sit tight. We're definitely going to have to build a little bit more of that. Do we have the airport technology? We do. Rabat, you're going to, I guess, finish the walls. Castle would also be nice because of happiness. Maybe we'll just build or buy an airport. Oh, I'm trying to decide. I suppose we could buy other things here. You know what? We will buy an airport because it's going to take too long to build otherwise. We want that so that there's no limit on how many air units we have over here. And it's going to be imperative that we know where her nukes are so that we can blow up her nukes before she hits us. What will be bad is if she has actual nuclear missiles as opposed to atomic bombs, because she can nuke us from out of range and maybe kill our stuff. But we'll probably be unloading all our nukes turn one, so we'll see how it goes. NB Battle Hunter, unproved uranium between Vancouver and Casablanca. Thank you very much. I don't know if it was on our borders yet, and we do have like tons of workers at this point, or we have a good slew of it. We actually have negative coal, so we're gonna get that hooked up pretty soon. Archaeology over here is out of range of our city, so we're gonna create an artifact like so. There might be a theming bonus we could do here. What do we need? Both type, same era, and matching civilization options. Well, temporarily, we could get a partial theming bonus. Oh, apparently we can't. I thought we could get... Oh, because one's art and one's an artifact. Canadian beads. Okay, let's see here. That's art. That's an artifact. That's another artifact. That's another artifact. And that's more art. So, I mean, yeah, we can't even get a theme bonus there. Can we get an English medieval work of art? The answer is no. We could get an ancient Ethiopian beads. And I don't know if we have a combo going on here. Oh, right. It doesn't have to be the same derp. It doesn't have to be the same country as long as they're not my country. So ancient, as long as they're not mine, will fit. So we can do that. We can get ancient Ethiopian beads and do a swap. It's not critical that we do it. Let's swap this ancient Canadian beads. Let's do that. And then, where is it? Down here. We have double ancient foreign artifacts. Okay. It's not going to be a huge deal because we're really limited to how many we can get. We don't really need that much tourism, but it's good to know. Kate! Just heard about the birthday. Grats on your ding! Yeah, that's right. I have leveled up. Thank you very much, Kate. Katie. Why don't we have a combo here? Ah, because it's not matching. It's the same thing. Different eras. Different eras and from civilizations other than mine. Oh. So I want two foreign works of writing. Well, that's going to be easy enough to do. And different eras as well. So a French industrial. And a Moroccan modern. There we are. All right, a little bit more. We'll stop futzing around with that. Police station for reduced spying, which is good. Another police station in London, which is good. Again, we won't need quite as many defensive spies. This is really good. I got English riflemen. They're hopelessly far behind. Korea's denounced France. I haven't denounced Russia yet, and we may want to do that at some point. Luckily, we're not friends. Well, luckily. Word that she might attack me. We'll see how it goes. Battlestar Galactica? I like that. What mod is the enhanced UI thing? It's called Enhanced UI. True story. Just Google it and you should find it. Okay, we have all our key stuff over here. We might want stadiums for happiness, especially if we start taking a lot of cities. Stock exchanges, all those things are really good. But I think what we need to do is start whipping out the military buildings. Oh, maybe we should get barracks and an armory. Or at least a barracks, because we do have total war. So with the barracks and the total war, we will get some upgrades. Okay, that's good. It's the correct religion and everything. Next turn. So many workers. And yeah, we'll get the uranium, which means we'll have more to build bombs with, which is good. It is out of range of a city, so we don't get to like get the extra hammers. Everyone is down to me. Well, Morocco's still alive. Okay. And we started Golden Age. That's amazing. Where the hell's Morocco? Oh, we can't see it. They do have an archaeologist over there, though. I thought Russia had taken all their stuff. So yes, I will purchase this airport. Maybe it doesn't have to be purchased white right yet, because it will cut down on my income. Yeah, let's not worry about it yet. I do want a castle because the extra defense is good. The happiness will be good. I can actually. Oh, France already lost its capital. To Russia! Oh! Fucking hell! Russia is. This is the problem. Russia just runs away with the game. Like, this is not me losing to Russia. It's just Russia destroying everyone else. And I haven't been touching Russia yet. I haven't had the opportunity to start a war with them yet. I'm gearing up to it as quick as I can. It's just, they're gonna take all the territory. There's a good chance we're just gonna lose. But we're gonna nuke the crap out of them before that happens. 4 turns away from the Manhattan Project. We do have our forward spies. Oh, I was waiting for one. Catherine is plotting against Ethiopia. Well, let's let Ethiopia know. She's gonna plot against everyone. Russia's the first culture to become influential with someone. Well, everyone else is getting microscopic, so that's not gonna be hard to do. Courthouse is done here. Good. Oh, we can get a pagoda going on here. Yes, let's do that. If we can get any other pagodas, we do want that to continue. It looks like no. What I need to do is start using my faith for great scientists so that we can light bulb some technology and really speed things along. Finish the research lab here. Good. We have an armory here. Very good. You know, we might want culture. We want temples for religion. We want stadiums for happiness. But I think short term, what we do is we build military units. We will have to do a bunch of stadiums and stuff. Because first of all, hockey is our religion, so obviously we need stadiums. And secondly, we are probably going to take a lot of cities. We have to take a lot of cities very fast. I mean, we might fail, But our plan has to involve the concept of taking a lot of cities really, really fast. Also, maybe getting some hospitals up would be good. I think it's worth actually putting down those hospitals now that I think about it. Vancouver's going to be busy for a really, really long time. Finish the courthouse in Casablanca. Nice. Research lab, pretty good. You have walls in a castle? You do. Well, we need to get all the research up first. Oh, I didn't tell you what. Let's build a university first. It's a little easier. Yeah, the frontline city might not get the hospital the same way. Archaeologist, archaeologist, worker. You know what? Finish the archaeologist you're working on. But that's it. We don't even have a research lab in our capital. Hang on. Let's purchase that right away. Yes, that was airport money, but we'll get there pretty fast. That's pretty important. If anything, I should have prioritized getting one there sooner. We don't need an airport here, although we could use the ferry troops to the front. I don't think it's going to be required. Hydro plant here would be very, very, very nice. In fact, start on that first for production. All right. Everyone's denouncing me. I haven't even done anything to Ethiopia. I haven't nuked anyone yet. Ethiopia is getting its butt kicked by Carthage. The problem is, at this point, Russia controls four capitals. They got Addis Ababa, Marrakesh, and Paris. But what happened here? We killed an English spy. Lovely. Guy has been promoted. Very, very nice. Guy is the one defending in Ottawa. In Harar, yeah, we'll never steal anything because they've got the freaking Great Firewall. We'll rig elections next turn, I suppose. And then we'll move you. Public school, yes, you're relatively front line. You might be a place to build units. Yeah, just start pumping out some military units. We'll get another mobile SAM going on. Your production rate is pretty low. That's because you actually don't work that many tiles. This is going to have to be fine. You have triumphed over us. I forgive you. Now leave me alone. Doubt Catherine will nuke Quillotine. I think she might just give him the good old Russian iron fist. Yeah, maybe. The AI does like to nuke back. They very frequently won't start a nuke, but they will nuke in response. Okay, I'm going to move this guy from... Oh, there's a chance I might coup them. I might kill him, but you know what? I'm going to give it a try. One third of the time, it'll work every time. Ah, well. We'll get our spy back, then we'll move into Saleh. Demands gems. We kill the Moroccan spy. We failed the coup. We grew. Embargo Russia. Yeah, I'd support that. Belgrade declares war on Ethiopia. Of course, Carthage takes over something else. Because the other thing Russia has is unlimited money. They have more land, more production, more science, and unlimited funds. We are sitting at 7 of 7 trade routes. We are. We're actually making good income. Some unit must have moved, so we'll just keep sort of scooching forward in that general direction. All right. Just turtle until that comes, XCOM, the new capitals and pair drop in. And that may be what happens. I mean, we could consider literally just doing that, only using nuclear missiles with maximum range and XCOMs. I forgive you. I want to make friends with everyone again. Morocco's pretty irrelevant. That's right. They're a pachyderm that doesn't matter. All right. Well, what I'm going to do is I'm going to build a couple of atomic bombs right away. We'll go back to normal focus. Get a couple of atomic bombs right away. And then we'll keep evaluating. All right, keep moving up. I'm worried if we turtletail XCOM, Russia's just going to have, like, built a spaceship by then. Our tech rate is going up pretty dramatically. And we're going to faith buy a great scientist in four turns. We're actually about to get a normal one very soon as well. Just finished a research agreement. That's nice. I don't suppose we can get another one with Carthage, could we? You want... I don't want to give you the aluminum. Or the oil. I need all that. There we go. Okay. Worth it. As long as she doesn't get wiped out or decide to declare war on me, but I don't know why Carthage would. Castle about done in Rabat. Give us more happiness, which is good. Courthouse in Casablanca will be done. Catherine's completed the SS booster. Now, that is not to be surprised. The AI really loves to build signed or spaceship parts as soon as it's an option. And boosters are one of the very first things you can build, right? She needs to get her particle physics and nanotechnology done because before she can finish it. But she will get there first. So that's why I'm not sure about waiting terribly long. Is a hydro plant here a good idea? Yeah, I think there's quite a bit of science. Now, we have to be careful. The hydro plants use aluminum. We don't have an unlimited supply. And we're going to need the rocket artillery. So I may just pass on that. It's probably worth getting a water mill down. Oh, no, we'll save up for the airport again, right? We could just build an arsenal here. It is the front line. But it shouldn't be too long. Let's actually go right into a barracks. Get all our military buildings done. Castle in Rabat. This is actually the real front line, now that I think about it. This is the place that needs the airport, right? I have to be careful about that. You need barracks? I think we take the same logic. Well, let's get the tech. All right, new policy. We can get another level 2 one. More happiness for barracks, armories, military academies. Everywhere's going to have barracks and armories, so we're going to get a lot of extra happiness from that. I think it's an excellent way to do it. We could also take the state police. More happiness from courthouses. Build courthouses in half the usual time. Obviously, you only build courthouses in cities you take over. At this point, that would be 3 cities? 4 cities. 4 cities could have courthouses. And anything we take over that we want to annex, that will be quite nice. I think, though, in the short term, the militarism will be better. We could get the third alternative, more strategic resources, a bunch of food and science in the capital, but I think that would be foolish. I think militarism will be better right now. Now, it is local happiness, so we are capped based on the size of the city, but we went from, what, 2 happiness to 20? No, we probably had a little bit more than that because these things had finished. But that was probably worth at least 10 extra global happiness. Plus, some of these cities are going to be at the happiness cap, which means when they grow, they'll actually still be fully happy, which is nice. We're going to run another trade route from here. Highest gold. Run it to Utik. And we got Charles Darwin. I don't know if we want to pop him now or wait a little bit longer. I mean, I don't want to do an academy with him. The science here is based on the amount of science you produce in, like, the last 8 turns or 10 turns or something. I don't think it's gonna change dramatically in the next few turns. So let's go ahead and pop that. We'll complete combined arms. Not that I really intend to really use tanks or anti-tank guns or the Pentagon. I think Catherine already built it, but we are just going to keep going forward. I guess I probably could have waited because our science would have gone up and probably would have been worth more in a few turns regardless. We have no interest in really anything at the computers either. We're just working up to our stealth bombers and XCOMs. I suppose I'll actually prioritize the XCOMs first because we do have nukes. Stealth bombers are stupendously good, though. Catherine did another booster, which is fine. Next turn. And we do have more uranium here. Actually, is that the one we have hooked up? Yeah, I think that one is hooked up. It's only the two. Cities we all like to visit. Tourism output. Well, 3 of them are legit Russian. And the other one is an Ethiopian capital. So she is putting out a lot of tourism, but I don't think she's going to win any sort of tourism victory. That is a big number. I'm pretty sure we're pretty defended. I might be wrong, though. If we look at Russia, what's their relationship with me? Familiar. It's not popular at 60. Influential in 158 turns. Yeah, that's fine. I mean, her output might start to go up, but of course, we might get to the point where we steal some cities ourselves. So I don't think she's going to win a cultural victory. I'm mostly worried about science or her deciding to kick my ass. Oh, I forgot to move my spy. No, that's right. He died. I got to wait until my spy respawns, and then I can move him to Saleh and keep an eye on there. Or even Addis Ababa. I think Saleh will be fine. Of course, once we take the first city, then the spy will get moved. Assuming everything works out. Barracks are done. Please add an arsenal into that. Assign delegates. She wants historical landmarks, which is just more culture. Although you can combo it with hotels and airports to get more tourism. Let's see if we can embargo Russia. We got another great scientist? Wow, they're coming fast. So the replacement spy has come up. So we will move you into Sale so we can keep an eye on things over there. Kept my border promise to someone. Someone who doesn't really matter anymore. I don't think we can upgrade anything to anything. Cavalry upgrades to a land ship? Really? Well, I want to make sure I buy the airport first. So let's not forget about the airport. Da, da, da. If Quill starts nuking the Russians, I would love to hear the nukes fly to the tunes of Bob Dylan's "The Time They Are Changing." Yeah, well, except that, of course, that would get us it would be a problem on the YouTube and things. So we didn't embargo Russia. We didn't get historical landmarks. Okay, well that's fine. Hospital in London. We should probably get a few more factories. Oh, we got plenty of coal now. We don't really need the coal for anything else. I think it makes sense to get that going, and then an armory. Ernest Rutherford. I guess since we're not rushing to computers, you know what? I will wait and as late as possible for more tech. So right now we'd get 7,000 beakers. So yeah, we would have gotten a little more if we'd saved that other guy. Next turn. Hey, Big Tone UK, thanks for the sub. There's no force or anything here, so they will go and hook that up. This turn is taking an abnormally long time to process. More SS boosters from Catherine. That's okay. She can spend all her time working on those boosters. I don't mind at all. Move stacked unit. All right. Archaeologist, we are going to go and put you here in Montreal. You can dig that up. She'll replace the forest, but that's okay. You're going to spread the religion here. Hockey, hockey, hockey. And Rutherford, 7074, we're over 1,000. Our science per turn is still climbing, I suppose. Really concerned about Russia. Sure, I probably don't have much of a market for that. Tell you what, I'll sell you the dyes first. I have more of those. I should be double checking to see who might be interested in anything. Not much. Basically, I'll come back. No, I decline. You'll probably declare war on them anyway and probably crush them, but I really don't want to encourage it, actually. I like that she's distracted, but not the fact that she's just dominating everything forever. Mobile Sam, done. Can do the military academy, which also gives us more happiness in addition to the XP. I forgot about that. We have all that stuff, huh? It's probably worth building the factory. I mean, I don't mind pumping out a unit or two, but we might still be waiting a little bit longer. And so, with that in mind, let's go and pop out those factories. 7125. So I guess we'll just wait to see when it doesn't really change anymore, and then maybe pop it then. No, I refuse, because you're mostly just going to go and plunder my artifacts. Da-da-da-da. Should watch Quill play a game. My brain fries because I have no idea how he works it all out. Well, I don't think I am going to work it out this time, actually. Think we're going to lose to Russia, but we're damn well going to try. Get a factory up in Ottawa. You're plotting. You're launching a sneak attack against someone. Well, I'm willing to bet it's a sneak attack against Korea. Since I have vision over her territory, she actually has very few units here whatsoever, which would be a hell of a time for us to declare war. In fact, there's a part of me is like, I could declare war now, maybe save Korea for a little while, and mostly just stop the big Russian juggernaut from rolling over everyone. But I need to make sure I've got my nukes. I'm working on the one, which is like just the one emergency nuke right now. But my plan was to like, pump out as many as I could everywhere. Science is still going up. That research lab just finished, so we'll get even more science from our guy if we wait longer. Let's go and get the factory up. We need to focus on the infrastructure a little bit longer. I'm worried about missing a timing window, but I think rushing too much would be a mistake. You finished the armory. We probably should have done the research lab first. You know what? Let's squeeze out the watermill first and then get that going. We'll try to have that base. University just finished. Let's Let's get a public school going on. And hope that we don't need to rush against Russia. We don't want to be Russian. And I think if we were rushing, then we might become Russian after she conquers us. Something. Definitely going to keep those. It's interesting that she annexed Saleh.